So click on the first one. So at the top, we can give the title of a product. Under the title, we can set the standard product. So I'll show you different types of product once I will explain these things. So this product is with the combinations. Combination means these attributes that we can have multiple colors of a product, we can have multiple sizes of a product, and we can set multiple values against these attributes. So while adding the product, it is actually called combination. Okay, so this has been set as the combination. So in the basic settings tab, we can set multiple images. First image will be selected as this cover image. Okay, if I open up any particular product from here, we can see the multiple images of this product that will be showing right here. Okay, other images will be shown under this bigger image. Okay, so at the right, we can set the reference number, we can set the price with the text excluded and with the text included. Okay, and this is the text rule. We should detect the tax 16%, or that has to be the 1%. Okay, and from here, these are the categories that has been selected for this product. Okay, so it has been shown in the home page, it is shown in the women's and dresses and the summer dresses, and it has a summary, it has the description, and under the summary you can see that it has added some features. So it selected the composition as a feature, and after selecting this composition, it has selected a value from this drop down. Okay, because it has further values, that's why it has selected drop down values. If I click on right here, and I can also add a customized value that is not available in this drop down. Okay, so we can add it right here. So these are the attributes that are shown right here. So we can have a style, and it has further values that we can select from here. We can add it from here. We can add a new feature, and we can choose a feature, let's say height, and we don't have any predefined value because height doesn't have any internal value. So we can say that we can have a 6 feet. Okay, so and other thing we can add is the brand. So fashion manufacturer, we had Phonex that I just added. So from here, we can change the brand from here. Okay, so this product is online means this is being visible right here. So that's why I'm showing on the front end. Okay, so we can add further category directly from here. It will take us to the category page to add a new category. And but I just want to explain you that while importing the products, we don't need to add categories, all these home, women. We just need to add a category that is at the lower level of the hierarchy, just like women and the summer dresses. Okay, so if I just add the summer dresses while importing the product, that I'll show you later on in the next video, that how to import products. While importing the products, we just need to add the innermost category, and it will automatically be added in its parent categories. Like if I add that product in the summer dresses, it will be added automatically within the dresses, and it will be added automatically within the woman category. So we don't need to select all these things. Okay, so but in latest version, it should work like this. Like it should work in the dresses and women if I just add the summer dresses right here. Okay, so it has been selected as combination. So let's click on combination. So these are the combination that has been selected from here. Oh, these are generated after selecting these values. So these are the combination that this product has: size small and the color yellow. It has a size medium and the color yellow. And we can set the quantity against each combination. That what is the quantity of small size having color yellow? What is the quantity of medium size having color yellow? And if I click on the added, I can set further things like it. Like for the medium product, I can set the cost price different than the smaller size product. I can set the text included product for multiple combinations. So it has a bunch of multiple features, very extensive and very easy to use. We can add an ISBN code, that is a reference code. We can add the weight, that for the large size product there will be more weight, for a small size product there will be less weight. Okay, so go back to product. So this is the major benefit and very important aspects and the attribute of this product that we can set. Okay, and I will create my own combinations once I will add my new product. I'm just explaining you guys these options. So we can set the shipping options, what is the width, height, depth and weight of our product that has been packed inside. So we can set the shipping fee. It has a zero shipping fee, means it is free of cost, will be shipped. So we can add the carriers. We need to select the carrier from here. If we don't select any carrier, then the all the carriers will be available. For if we click on the add to cart, and all the carriers will be available, and the user will be user can just click on the add to cart and select any carrier that he wants. Okay, if we can set the pricing of this product, in the basic settings we could add the pricing, but these are the tab that has more features other than these, some basic features. Okay, so prices, we can add the text rule, price text excluded, we can price add price per unit. Okay, so cost price, we can add the specific price, add different categories that in what circumstances what should be the price is. We can add the priority management, we can set SEO and the options, and these are the obvious things. So moving further, let's add a new product. So click back catalog and the products tab and click on add new product. Okay, so that is, let's add a new product name like shirt one. That is a product name, and we can have three types of products. We can have a standard product that will just have standard product, and it has a summary, it has a description, and these are the combinations of it. We can have a pack of products, like we have already added a product, just like we had have added a product shirt, we have added a product hat, we have added a product shoes, and we want to combine this product and sell it in a combined form. Okay, so we can set a separate price for this combination of products, and then we can set the pack of products, and from here we can search different products that are already added, and then we can just add this all the products within this pack of products. So virtual product is something called, if we want to sell something online, like we want to sell a book, we want to sell a video, we want to sell a tutorial series, we can upload these things, we can upload the files right here, and user has to pay from here, and he will be able to download or watch videos or download books or things like these. So this is a virtual product. So let's add a standard product, and this product is product with combination. So let's add a shirt, and we can add a feature, we can add a brand. So let's make it online first, and we can add a related product as well. So let's click on the combination first. So from right we can select the sizes, like small and medium. This shirt has small and medium sizes, and it has red and black color. Okay, so let's generate these combination. Wait for it and click on this button, and it will add the all the permutations of these combination, and will be created right here like these. We have a small size red color, we have a small size black color, we have a medium size red color, we have a medium size black color. We can set the quantity. Let's add the 10, 10, 10 and 10, and we can set the price for each of this combination. Okay, but I don't want to go to these details. These combinations has been added. Use default behavior, deny orders. So let's click on allow orders. Label when in stock, so I want to show you available. Label when out of stock, out of stock, and availability date is 14. Okay. So let's save the combinations of this product, and once it is saved, we'll go back to the basic settings and we will add a few important things that we needed to add. So go to basic settings. We can have a reference number. Let's add a price like 1000 PKR, and text included. We have set the 16% for the text in Pakistan. That is the 16% text, and we can set the category. So click on the home, woman, tops, and click on the hat. Okay, so this has been added to the hat category. Okay, we can add a new category. So let's click on shipping. It has a width in centimeters, so 20 centimeter 20. It has a depth 2 centimeter, and weight is 1 kg. Okay, shipping fee is free. We don't want to set any carrier. Let's click on pricing. It has been updated. I don't want to mess with these things. We don't need to add the cost price unless we want to show it to the users. In the options, so let's click on the save, and it is saving, and it should be available in our front end because it is online and it is within this hat category. So reload it and it should show the product. So woman, tops, hat, click on hat, and you can see that this product has been shown. If I click on this product, it has shown me the detail page of this product. I can have a combinations like small, medium. Okay, I can set the color, and I didn't add any description or features because that's why it didn't show all the features and the details. Product detail will show the description, and product and the features tab will show all the features. This is where under the text included text, we can show the summary. Okay, so this is how we can add a product in our PrestaShop. Okay, so let's go to products. And you can see that this product has been added within this list. One thing I want to see is if I click on tops, does it show the product that is in a hat? So as I told you before, that we don't need to enter or add the parent category to any product. I just added the hat, and it is automatically being shown in the tops category. So in the default products, like these products, it is unnecessarily added all the categories, all the hierarchy of categories that is not required. Okay, so that's great. So that's for it for this video. In the next video, I'll show you how to import categories, brands, and how to import products. If you have a store, you might not want to add each product one by one. That is very hectic job. You must have all the products in Excel file or in the CSV file that you can import it just by clicking on this import button, and it will let you select different settings that what are the attributes of the product should be and how you can import the products. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned and see you in the next video.